Welcome to final BSc statistics students. In paper 6 in unit 1 today we discuss lesson 4 control charts. The definition of control charts: a control chart is a device and a graphical representation of collected information. What is meant by collected information? We have discussed previously in statistical quality control definition. SQC means, statistical quality control means planned collection and effective use of the data. Planned collection, you see, you observe here, collected information. So that means we have to collect information according to some kind of principles. So here the very important point is, from a lot of items, which means the item produced in a day, usually we consider a lot. From a lot of items, we have to consider a sample number of items at regular intervals of time for which we have to collect the information. What kind of information? Some kind of measurement. We have to collect some measurements to that particular item. For example, a car manufacturing company produces cars. So for which you have to examine the specified standards of the car. For example, mileage. What kind of mileage it gives? So we have to consider a sample of items at random, at regular intervals of time, for every 20 minutes or 30 minutes. We have to consider a manufactured car. And then we have to test the mileage, examine the mileage of that car at the end product. So which means we have to note it down. So such information, such collected information. Similarly, another example, a manufacturing company produces electrical fans, for which we have to examine what is the average lifespan of the electrical fan, so that whether it is meeting the specifications. So for which you have to measure what is the average lifespan, that we have to test based on some particular sample time period. So for which it is going to be measured. So the measurement is going to be noted down, the average lifetime of a particular item. So these are to be examined, these are to be collected from the collected sample number of items. For all the sample number of items which are collected, which are taken from the lot, for which you have to collect the information regarding whatever the population characteristic is going to be studied. So for all sample observations, sample units, we have to collect the measurement. That is called collected information. For which this collected information, it's going to be represented graphically. And such kind of graphical representation is known as control chart. But of course, you have to do something else. Some other points also to be pointed out, which are to be plotted in the control chart, just not a graphical representation. So such kind of graphical representation of collected information is known as control chart. Control chart is a statistical device which is mainly used for studying and controlling a repetitive process. What is meant by a repetitive process? The repetitive process means a process, simply it is repeated for manufacturing various items. As usually we know, if any particular manufacturing company manufactures an item, the process will be one. The same process will be applied to manufacture remaining all other items. Therefore, the same kind of process is going to be repeated and repeated again, again and again. Such kind of repetitive process is known as repetitive process, in which now we have to study what are the causes of variation. We have to study the causes of variation and we have to keep the repetitive process under control. That is the main purpose of constructing the control chart. Why we are constructing a control chart? Because of this basic reason. We have to identify this particular basic reason. The main purpose of constructing the control chart is to identify certain reasons. That is, we have to study the reasons. What are the reasons of variation? And we have to control such variation in a particular repetitive process. For example, defective raw material. Taking defective raw material, improperly handling the machines, improper adjustment of the machines, wrongly operating by the operators, etc. So due to which kind of reason, which reason the process is not going to run properly, it's not under control, it is not controlled. So those kind of variation are going to be observed. That is nothing but study. Study of repetitive process is nothing but to identify what are the reasons for variations in the process. Fine. Next, controlling. Obviously, no need to explain. Controlling the repetitive process at every particular time period. Always the repetitive production process must be under control. So these two are the main objectives, main uses of constructing the control chart. So control charts are simple to construct and easy to interpret. Interpretation and construction, which are very easy for control chart. Its construction is based on plotting 3σ limits and a sequence of suitable sample statistics, for example mean, range, standard deviation, etc., computed from independent samples drawn at random from the production process. So for which we have to calculate the mean, range, standard deviation, etc. That is for the collected information measurements. And then based on suitable sample statistic, we have to calculate 3σ limits. We will discuss later. 3σ control limits, and then we have to draw a particular control chart. Control chart is constructed based on plotting 3σ control limits, and so all this procedure. If you move to the next slide, control chart consists of three horizontal lines. Control chart is mainly depends on these three horizontal lines. One, central line. Two, upper control limit. Three, lower control limit. Central line is abbreviated as CL. Upper control limit is read as UCL. Lower control limit is known as LCL. The central line indicates standards of the process. Remember, it is very important. It is not a control limit. Central line is a line which indicates standards of the process. CL. Upper control limit and lower control limits are control limits. It is there itself in this particular terminology, which are two control limits. Whatsoever the sample drawn, the measurement of the sample unit must be within these two limits, lower limit and upper limit. Simply, lower control limit, upper control limit, between LCL and UCL. Okay, and here we plot in the graph. Central line CL is plotted as bold horizontal line, whereas UCL and LCL are plotted as dotted horizontal lines. Now, what are the formula? Formula of control limits. Control limits, the formula is also specified for CL, but control limits are only UCL and LCL. Remember, only the control limits are UCL and LCL. UCL is expectation of T plus R plus 3 into standard error of T. UCL is expectation of T plus 3 into standard error of T. What is expectation of T? Mean. Mean of T. Standard error of T is square root of variance. And LCL, lower control limit, it is calculated with the formula expectation of T minus 3 into standard error of T. You observe these two formulas. Only the difference is with plus and minus. The formula consists of same terms. Only the difference is plus and minus. With plus upper control limit, with minus lower control limit. And CL, central line, it is calculated by expectation of T. That is usually average of T. Expectation of T is nothing but average of T. So, which indicates average standards of the process. Simply to specify, central line indicates standards of the process. Now, conclusions based on control charts. The sample point fall, all the sample point, if all the sample point fall within upper and lower control limits, then the process is said to be under control. And the second conclusion, if any one of the sample point found outside the control limits, the process is said to be out of statistical quality control. It is a very simple description. Now we move on to the example. We consider a sample control chart and we discuss. You see here, this is one of the sample control chart I have taken. You see in x-axis how to construct. You observe and keep the points in mind. In x-axis, we consider sample number. How many samples we have considered, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on, etc. up to 20 or 24. On y-axis, we consider quality scale. What is meant by quality scale? We can consider a particular measurement. For example, mean, range, sample mean, I specify clearly, sample mean or sample range or sample standard deviation, sample proportion, etc. Now you observe, based on the sample points we consider for sample 1, we calculate sample mean, for example, quality scale. For example, you consider T is sample mean, average, then we have to calculate sample mean for first sample. And we have to draw one particular point. You observe the points there, corresponding to one particular point is there, point. You draw the point. And again you consider second sample, and you make another point, that is you will get one another sample mean of the second sample mean. You draw a particular point on the graph, and similarly third, fourth, fifth, etc. And you join the points. For example, this is one picture between LCL and UCL. First of all, I specify CL, LCL and UCL. Whatever the CL, it is indicated expectation of T, that is average of the value statistic T. For a statistic T, we have to calculate mean. The mean is nothing but CL, expectation of T, it is CL. You consider CL is nothing but expectation of T. You plot the value here and you draw a bold horizontal line for CL, central line. That indicates standards of the process. And you observe UCL and LCL. Calculate by using the formula. Compute the values UCL and LCL. And you plot as dotted horizontal lines. And then now you observe if all the points, likewise we join the points, all the points between the UCL and LCL, there is one picture observed. So such kind of representation, if all the points between the LCL and UCL, LCL and UCL, then the process is said to be under statistical quality control. That is it, the process is under control. Now you observe above UCL there is one point which was rounded off and written as out of control, which means if any single point falls above UCL, the procedure, that process is said to be out of statistical quality control. Similarly, you observe below LCL there is one point which is also rounded off, one point which is rounded off and written as out of control. So therefore you take the conclusion for this is any point fall below LCL, any one point fall below LCL, then the process is also said to be out of statistically quality control. It is not under control. No need to have above UCL one point, below LCL another point. No. If any one point below LCL, then also the same conclusion. If any one of the point above UCL, no need to have both the points. One point below LCL, one point above UCL. No such consideration. Only the consideration is any one of the point either below LCL or above UCL, that is outside the control limits. Outside the control limits, if you have any single point, then the process is said to be out of statistical quality control. Thank you. Thank you very much.